Hi Michael, Phil Beever here from the Wilderness Club. Just want to recap on our lesson yesterday. So starting to swing it really good. Just a couple of pointers we've got to really tidy up. One is, the first thing is this takeaway. We've got to sort that out. It just starts to chain your backswing badly if that club head goes outside of that red line. And that red line's not even straight, but we can see that it's going away. And what that does, it gets that left arm to separate. And with this left arm now, at this stage here, is too far away from you. If we look at Rose here, we draw a line on his club head and just have a look at his swing, you're going to see the first move is that them hands are going in, that club head staying out, and his left arm now, if we draw a line, his left arm is matching his feet line, where if we draw a line on your left arm, it's not on the same line as your feet. So we need to get that left arm coming in a little bit, Michael. Top of swing, perfect as usual, you know, great looking swing there. Really happy with the club face, left arm, right elbow, really, really solid. If we look here at Rose at the top, you know, he's going to look a little bit more upright, but otherwise not a lot of difference. The only difference is his club head is going a bit more down the line and yours is laid off, which actually I prefer yours, and yours is probably a little bit stronger. The big difference now of Rose, as he starts to unwind, you know, as he starts down, he's feeling that he's putting pressure into his left foot. Now what that's doing, that's just trying to hold his hips as his arms are coming down in front. So we're trying to get the arms to beat that right hip coming down. And also we can see the shaft on his club has not dropped underneath the forearm. You know, it's still above the forearm there. So if we draw some lines at this frame sort of here, halfway down, we'll see the shaft is going to stay on that red line club head. We do the same for you as we start to come down. One, I feel like your legs are still a bit too active, okay, but also if we look at this, you're going to see your shaft drops underneath that red line, okay, where Rose again all the way into impact pretty much is on that red line. So he's just in a slightly better position, slightly more in front, so he can't hit the ball left from there. But yours is caused really by them hips just still spinning a tiny bit too much. We can see this foot's coming off the ground. Look at Rose's foot. You know, he's just rolling as opposed to yours is coming up on its toe. And that's just a sign, Michael, that, you know, the hips are spinning rather than you putting pressure into the left foot. So I need you to feel like you put some pressure into that left foot. Arms are going to come down a little bit steeper, and don't forget, just keep feeling that like you're going to swipe left and across it for me as opposed to out to the right. I mean, the club face here is perfect, but we need to get that feeling that we're just going to pull left and across. And right at the end, I ask you just to try and feel like you start the ball left and cut it back, and you did a terrific job. So it's just holding that right hip back, pushing into that left foot, really delays the hip spin. Gets the arms time to get down and in front, and then we can just pull across it left and hit that baby little cut. Thanks, Michael.